In this video, I teach you a column and knee type milling machine. In video, I explain you various components of column and knee type milling machines. So, before starting this component, I just explain why its name is column and knee type. So, in this milling machine, that is a one component is column and another component is the knee. That's why it is known as the column and knee type milling machines. So, we know that human body have a one part, it is known as the knee. In our leg, knee is there. So when we bend our leg, then this our leg is take like this shape. Okay, that's why it is known as the knee. So this is our knee, this is the hip joint, and this is the finger of our leg. Okay, that's why its name is given as column and knee type milling machine. Now next we understand the component. So first component is the base. Okay, so this is the base. So it is the bottom part of the milling machine, that's why its name is the base. So what is the function of the base? It is foundation member for all the other parts which rest upon it. Means all other parts of the machines are mount on the base. It carry the column at its one end, means this is a one end and this is another end. So at the one end, here the column is mounted. It act as a load taking member for all other parts of the machines and a reservoir for the coolant. Means it take the load of all other parts of the machines, and sometimes in this base we are stored the coolant that is required during this cutting. And this base is generally made from the cast iron materials because cast iron have a good compressive strength. So these bases absorb all the compressive loads coming out from these other components. That's why it is manufacturing from the cast iron and by using this casting process. Second component is the column. The column is mounted on the one end of the base. So we understand the meaning of this column. Column is the main supporting member mounted vertically on the base. So this is the main supporting members. And this column is support the all other parts of the machine. That's why it is known as the main supporting member. It is a box shape heavily ribbed inside. Means its shape is like box and it have a six side. Four side and one is in bottom and one on the top side. So bottom is connected with the base and the top is connected with this overarm. And on this side different guideways are provided. On that the knee are mounted. And what is the meaning of heavily ribbed inside? Means it is a hollow component, and inside this hollow that is a various support is provided. It is known as the rib insides, and house all the driving mechanisms for the spindles and table feed. Means inside this column we are providing the driving mechanisms like motor to running the arbors, and here the another motor is provided for a table feed. So different mechanisms are provided inside this column. The front vertical face of the column is accurately machined. Means this side of the column is accurately machined, and it's provided dovetail guideway for supporting the knee. So on this side the dovetail shape guideways is provided. So here I show you this dovetail guideway. This is a dovetail guideways. So this part, this upper part is mounted on this column. And this shape is installed on the knee. So knee is moving up and down. Because it is in figure you see it is a horizontal. But here it is mounted in vertical positions. Okay. On the top of the column, overarm is supported. Means this is the top part of the column. So here one component is added. It is known as the overarm. Now before moving ahead, I request to like the video, comment on the video and subscribe the channels. For watching this different video of this manufacturing process and other subject of the mechanical engineering, you visit the playlist where the various subject video is available. Now next component is the overarm. Because it is installed in the top part, that's why it is known as the overarm. It is mounted on the top of the column, which is extended behind the column face. So it is the end of the column face. So it is extended from this column face. And serve as a bearing support for another end of the arbor. So it supports the another end of the arbor. To support the projecting arbor, it can slide horizontally forwards and backwards and adjusted at required positions. So on this overarm, also the dovetail type guideways is provided for this moment of this yoke. Okay. Now next component is the front brace. The front brace is a extra support which is fitted between the knee and overarm to ensure the further rigidity to the another end of the armor. So every machine this front brace is not available. In some of the machines you see it is a front brace and it is support the knee and this overarm. Next is the yoke. So this yoke is provide the support to the armor. So armor is installed here. So another end of the armor is supported by the yoke and yoke are able to slide on the overarm because this yoke is mounted on the dovetail guideways on the overarms. So yoke are able to moving from this side to this according to this length of the armor. Next component is the spindle. So this is the spindle hub. It is situated in the upper part of the column and receive the power from the motor. So these spindles are mounted in upper part of the column and it receives the power from the motor through belts, gear and clutch and transmit it to this armor. So electric motor is mounted here. So it transmits the power to the spindle by using the any mechanisms. And then this spindle is further transmit its power to the armor. So this is the next component is armor. So one end of the armor is connected with this spindle. Another end is connected or supported by the yoke. So it is the horizontal type column and knee type milling machines. It may be vertical armor is also installed it. Then it is known as the vertical column and knee type milling machines. So in a exam you are able to draw any type of these vertical or horizontal column knee type milling, it is the correct. You just need to draw the knee here. Okay, this is the important things and the column here. So armor, it is like an extensions of the machine spindle. So it is a one type of the extensions of the spindle on which milling cutters are securely mounted and rotated. So on this armor, the milling cutters are mounted. The armor are made with the taper shank for a proper alignment with the machine spindles and having a taper hole at their nose. Okay, so if you want to study the various type of the armors, then go to the playlist and watch the video of types of armors. So I not explain this topic in detail here. To draw bolt, it is used for managing, for locking the armor with the spindles. Means here one draw bolt is provided. It is used to locking the armor with the spindles and the whole assembly. The armor assemblies consist of the following components. First one is the armor, you see in this figure, and spindle. Different spacing collar are provided to adjusting the locations of the milling cutters. Then the bearing bus, cutter, draw bolt, lock nut, key block and set screw. These are the various component used for armor. Now the next component is this milling cutter. So milling cutter is mounted on the armors. So its location is not fixed. It is installed here. It may be installed here by removing the spacings. So by using these various spacing collars, we are able to adjust the milling cutters in any positions of the armor. Now next component is the knee. And this knee is supported by the elevating screw or a screw jack. So it is a one type of the screw. Either it is elevating screw or a screw jack. So it is operated by using the automatic mechanisms. Means by using this electric motor or by hydraulic mechanisms. Knee is the rigid gray iron casting which slide up and down on the vertical way of the column face. So in earlier case, means when we study the column, I tell you that here one dovetail guideways are provided. So on these dovetail guideways, the knee are mounted. So these dovetail guideways are verticals. So our knee are able to move up and down. Okay. So, due to this up and down movement, which things are controlled? So, by operating the screw jack or elevating screw with the help of hand wheel or power feed, the table height can be adjusted. Means table height is adjusted or a space between this cutter and the table is adjusted by moving the knee up and down, and knee is moving up and down by using the screw jack or elevating screw, and this screw jack or elevating screw are operate by using the hand wheel or either by using the power feed. With the moment of the knee, table height or a distance between the cutter and workpiece can be adjusted. So it is depend on the height of the workpiece. So we need to moment the knee. If the workpiece height is small, then we need to move knee upper directions. When the workpiece height is larger, then we need to move knee in the downward direction. Next component is the saddle. So saddle is mounted on the top surface of the knee. So this part is known as the saddle, and the saddles are moving in this horizontal direction, means to and fro from the column. So we move the saddles near to column or away from the column. Intermediate parts between the table and knee, which act as a support for the table. So it is an intermediate part from the knee and table. So table is mount on the saddle. So it is like the in between the table and knee. To provide cross fit to the table, the saddle can be adjusted crosswise. So this saddle moment is known as the crosswise fit, or it is known as the cross fit along the guideways provided on the top of the knee. So this saddle is mounted on the guideways that is provided on the top surface of the knee, and this moment of the saddle is known as the cross fit, and the knee motion is known as the up and down motion. Horizontal guideways are provided at the top of the saddle along which the table can be moved in a longitudinal directions, means on the surface of top surface of the saddle one longitudinal guideways is provided that is not seen in this, means in another direction like this vertical and horizontal. Then in this another direction that is not imagined in this figure, but I show you in this next image how it is occurs. On that guideways are provided in longitudinal directions. On that longitudinal directions our tables are moved. Next component is the table. So table is mount on a guideways of the saddle, and this is the hand wheel for the table. So by using this hand wheel we move the table in the longitudinal directions. The table rests on the saddle and travels longitudinally. A lead screw under the table, means inside this table one lead screw is provided. So a lead screw under the table engage a nut on the saddle. So one nut is provided on the saddles. So this screw is engaged with the nut on the saddle to move the table horizontally by hand or a power. A universal machines, the table may also be swivels horizontally, means it is inclined at a certain angles in universal machine. For this purpose the table is mounted on a circular base, means when we need to swivel at different angles to this table, at that time this table is mount on a circular base. The top of the table is accurately finished and the T-slots are provided, means top of these tables are accurately finished, and on the sides of the table various T-sections is provided. Okay, and these T-sections are used to clamping the work and other fixtures under it. Next part is the workpiece. So on this table the workpiece is mounted by using this T-bolt and nut and different clamping devices. So here in this image we see the motions. So this is the knee component. This knee is moving up and down. Next is the saddle. So how the saddle is moving? So saddle is moving in these directions, and it is known as the cross fit. So this moment is indicate this saddle is moving near to the column and away from this column. And next motions of the table, that is the longitudinal directions. So these directions the table is moving. So this we consider it is x direction, and the saddle is in y directions. Then knee is moving in this z directions of the cutting tools. In this image here you see that it is the vertical axis milling cutters. In a last case we see in this figure it is a horizontal milling cutter. So any type is possible for the knee type, either it is horizontals or a verticals. So thank you for watching this video. If you learned, then like the video, subscribe the channels and share with your friend.